There are these kinds of information that when you learn them, you just keep thinking to yourself, if only I knew this sooner. Especially when this information could have made you progress more quickly in whatever you're doing. For instance, if only I knew that banana peels are amazing fertilizers, I would never have thrown them away. So today I'm going to teach you 5 amazing organic vegan fertilizers that you might already have at home, but you may not be aware of. And trust me, the 5th one is really something. Let's go. Hi guys, I'm Jonathan from my vegan permaculture world, and today I'm going to teach you 5 simple yet valuable hacks to help your plants grow stronger and deficient free fertilizers. Yes, fertilizers are materials applied to the soil to supply essential nutrients for the plant's growth. They can be natural or synthetic, but as permaculture is about mimicking nature, I will only be talking about the natural ones. And don't worry, I won't be going through too much technical information. I'm pretty sure you can find more details anywhere on the internet. So, without further ado, number 1.
Vegetable cooking water. I really enjoy cooking, especially when the vegetables are homegrown. But I'm not a fancy cook. I would rather keep everything simple yet tasty. Nothing better than putting everything in the cooking pan, add some water, some fresh herbs on your garden, some seasoning, and let it cook nicely. When the veggies are cooked, drain off the water but do not throw it away. The water is full of nutrients leaked out of the vegetables. Allow it to cool before using it in your plants. You might as well dilute it with some more water if it's too concentrated. Number 2. Coffee grounds. I'm not a huge fan of coffee, but it's always nice to have one during a cold rainy day along with a piece of chocolate cake, right? Between, this is an amazing homemade vegan chocolate cake, really easy to do, and it requires only a few ingredients. If you want a recipe, let me know in the comments. I might as well make a little video on this later. The scent of a warm coffee easily invades my tiny house and makes me feel comfy. Oh, sorry, I lose myself. Let's get back to our subject. For years, I have been throwing my coffee grounds in the bin without knowing they can be used in the garden. It's a great snail repellent, but also an amazing fertilizer. Not to be put in huge quantities into the ground, but a handful from time to time will benefit your soil life and your plants. Number 3. Banana peels and overripened bananas. This is the one I really wish I knew earlier. I live in a tropical island, and here, bananas grow everywhere. I always have some for breakfast on my pancakes, during the day as snacks, in my smoothies, and after dinner as dessert. And this makes a nice amount of banana peels each day. And for years, I have been tossing the overripened bananas in the bin without even a goodbye look. Anyway, overripened bananas or banana peels are high in potassium, phosphorus, calcium, and so on. Everything that plants love. You can bury them near your plants, make banana peels overnight infusion, or just put them in the compost. Trust me on this, you won't regret it. Have your infusion filtered and mix it with some water. You can put the remaining organic materials directly in your vegetable's garden. This process is called direct composting. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you want to learn more about this amazing composting method. I'll be covering this in the coming videos. Water underneath foliage to make sure the roots get as much nutrients as possible. Number 4. Liquid grass fertilizer. Who doesn't like the smell of freshly cut grass? It feels like summer is here. Vegan barbecue in the garden, fresh lemonade from homegrown lemons, straw hat. Okay, stop dreaming guys, it's not what we're talking about. One of the best fertilizers you can do at home is liquid grass fertilizer. Grab a bucket, fill it 2/3 with fresh grass clipping, add water until the bucket is full, let it brew for 2 to 4 days. Don't forget to give it a good mix once or twice a day. After 4 days, have it filtered. Do not use it directly on your plants. Dilute 1 pot of liquid gross fertilizer with 4 pots of water. You can soak your plants completely with this infusion. It will not only boost your plants' growth as gloss clipping is full of nitrogen, but it will also act as a pest repellent. Number 5. Fresh urine. Yes, it may sound weird, but your bladder produces one of the most amazing fertilizer you can put your hands on, or in, or whatever, and it's totally free. It's so rich in potassium, phosphorus, nitrogen, and other minerals, and it is delivered in a form that is easily absorbed by plants. Mix 1 pot of fresh urine with 10 pots of water. For obvious reasons, it should be applied underneath foliage and fruits, and watch your plants grow strong, healthy, and give amazing fruits.
Here you are, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. Tell me in the comment section which one you like best. And if you have more tricks on vegan homemade fertilizers, send me an email on my veganpermacultureworld@gmail.com and I will be more than happy to do another video about it. Give the video a thumbs up if you found it informative. It's always nice to know when your work is appreciated. And don't forget to subscribe to be informed of future uploads. Guys, I wish you all a nice day. Peace.